Jimmy Fallon welcomes Jerry Seinfeld. NBC Tonight.
You're sleeping with a cooperating informant.
We grew up the same. I get her. She gets me.
You're putting yourself in danger. You don't just lose your job. You go to prison. Come with me.
Chicago PD. New next Wednesday on NBC and Peacock.
I want Rob out of here.
I'm fighting for my life.
You're mentally drained, physically exhausted. Oh, one more thing. What's inside that case is a game changer.
Deal or No Deal Island. Monday on NBC.
Live on NBC 12, this is News Watch 12 at 10.
Good evening, I'm Jessica Jukic. An incumbent Wisconsin senator has not lost re-election since 2010. Senator Tammy Baldwin is hoping to continue that trend in November. The Democrat continued her cross-state campaign swing with a stop in Wausau today. She met with Mayor Katie Rosenberg at a coffee shop downtown and visited three other small businesses. Baldwin said a lot of people are concerned about high costs. She brought up the example of how diaper input costs have gone down significantly, but big companies aren't passing those savings on to customers.
It's gone down 25%, but the company has not reduced the price of the product. And I think part of what we can do there is just shine the spotlight on them.
Baldwin pointed to recent success with this strategy. Three inhaler companies have capped prices at $35 after Baldwin started an investigation into their high prices. Wausau Mayor Katie Rosenberg thanked Baldwin for her support of Wausau, including $3 million for the Wausau Fire Department, allowing the city to hire more firefighters.
And she's also given us a congressionally directed appropriation through the budget process to help remediate PFAS. So if there's anybody who's worth reelecting, it's certainly Senator Baldwin.
After Wausau, Baldwin made three more stops today, meeting with supporters at small businesses in Waupaca, Appleton, and Fort Atkinson. Conrad, it was a cold night. We had some snow flurries out there.
Yes, we did. Yeah, Jessica, still a little bit of flurries left, but most of that heavy snow, long gone, right? Say goodbye to that. Not quite for the rest of the season, but overall, though, we are going to be clearing up by tomorrow. An abundant amount of sunshine is in store for us for the day on Thursday and Friday as well. Just some flurries left over, and that's going to continue overnight tonight. Up north, though, right up into the UP, winter weather advisories have been issued, and also some winter storm warnings still posted till around 8 a.m. on 8 a.m. tomorrow, and then things will finally start to improve. But snowfall wise, though, wow, finally feeling like winter, right? Around 2 inches of snow here in town, and we're going to continue to see staying consistent by tomorrow with temperatures in the mid-30s, a little bit less right by Wausau, and then down south, of course, no snow by Milwaukee and Madison as well. Into Illinois, no way, you melted that snow away. Temperature-wise, though, we were in those mid to upper 20s earlier today, still sticking around in those low to mid-20s. Down south, look at that, Waupaca area, Green Bay, near freezing. Overnight tonight, though, we're going to continue to see these scattered snow showers, temperatures back in those mid-teens. Jessica?
Thank you, Conrad. Two police departments are merging together, and they have named the new chief of police. The newly formed Mountain Bay Metropolitan Police Department has named the current Rothschild Police Chief Jeremy Hunt as the new chief. Rothschild and Everest Metro Police Departments will soon merge into one single department. The commission made the decision on the new police chief during today's meeting. The departments will begin working together in the next couple of weeks. The new department will operate out of the current Rothschild Police Department building. The United States is seeing a rise in measles, polio, and other communicable diseases. These diseases had been declining ever since vaccines were developed, but now childhood vaccination rates are declining. There are a few reasons why. A lot of care was disrupted during the pandemic, and many routine vaccinations were missed. But there's also a growing vaccine hesitancy towards vaccine, according to health officials.
We see a lot of vaccine hesitancy regarding safety, regarding trust.
Melissa Briner said these routine vaccines have been rigorously studied and are safe, but inaccurate and misleading information from unreputable websites and social media posts have played a part in some vaccine skepticism.
Hopefully we can regain trust in vaccines again completely. It's just, like I said, it's getting the correct information. It's talking to your healthcare provider. It's advocating and making, being able to make the best decisions for you and your family.
She said all the vaccines that are recommended are very important in preventing certain diseases. She urges people to have vaccine-related conversations with their doctors. On Tuesday, the FDA approved a drug that may help stop and even reverse a rare fatal blood vessel condition doctors call a ticking time bomb. Pulmonary arterial hypertension, or PAH, is diagnosed in less than 1,000 Americans every year. The condition causes blood vessels to thicken, making the heart work harder to get blood to the lungs. Without treatment, people with PAH usually only live 2 to 3 years after their diagnosis. The drug helps keep the patient's blood vessels from thickening, improving blood flow. A Bayfield County restaurant is holding a fundraiser for Northland College in Ashland. The college is in danger of closing unless it can raise $12 million by April 3rd. Delta Diner is hosting an event at the diner on Friday benefiting Northland College. The fundraiser will be held on Friday from 8 a.m. to 2 p.m. at Delta Diner, and they'll be offering a unique menu of established and new dishes. All food and non-alcoholic beverage purchases for the day will be donated to the college. A new report from the Wisconsin Policy Forum shows that homeless populations continue to rise across the state. According to the report, Wisconsin saw a 1.8% increase in the amount of homeless individuals. This is the second straight year that the state has seen an increase in homelessness after seeing a 30% drop between 2014 and 2021. The report points to layoffs and hardships caused by the pandemic and the end of pandemic relief funds as a driving force behind the change. The Wisconsin Realtors Association recently released its February 2024 Wisconsin Real Estate Report. The monthly report on the housing market is compared to the same month of the previous year. The 2024 February report stated that the average median price in Wisconsin rose and sits right around $275,000.
Real estate listings are up by almost 21%. We are also seeing price increases, which is good for sellers, but maybe not so good for buyers. It's up about 6%.
Cicely Dawson is a broker that covers the Northwoods. She says that here in the north central Wisconsin area, the sales were higher than the rest of the state compared to this time last year.
Statewide, the improvement was 3%. There were 3% more sales in February this year over last year. But in the northern region, it was 34.5% more sales this February. So we saw a ton more sales.
Larson and Dawson say home buyers still see some of the most challenges are the first-time home buyers. Wisconsin lakes and rivers are full of wildlife and plants, but unfortunately some garbage. But a Northeast Wisconsin scuba diver has been cleaning our rivers and lakes and recently found an interesting treasure. Ed Bieber has been cleaning the waterways for around 5 years now under the name Ed the Diver. When Bieber goes into a waterway, he said that he can clean out around 100 pounds of trash or even more depending on the items.
When I have my kayak, we're throwing bicycles in there, rims, brake parts, lures, what other, cans, bottles, glasses, you name it, we found it in there.
Bieber said his most recent interesting find was a 1990s Barbie doll that he found while cleaning the Wolf River. After a few friends recommended Bieber sell the Barbie, he decided to start an auction on eBay, starting at 99 cents, and it has now grown to $450. Ed the Diver will be having a tour in May, June, and July, allowing people to follow where he's at and possibly help clean up. Cleanup is underway in Baltimore after a deadly bridge collapse. Coming up, we'll have the latest on the recovery efforts after Weather with Conrad right here on Newswatch 12.
Imagine yourself in a new Toyota.
Yeah.
Sick.
Whoa. Oh, yeah.
Right now, get 3.99% APR for 60 months, plus $1,000 cash back on Tundra Hybrid when you finance through Toyota Financial Services.
Ready, set, go get your Toyota today.
Toyota, let's go places.
Getting results for Wausau. That's Katie Rosenberg. As mayor, Katie has worked hard to ensure everyone in Wausau has access to safe, PFAS-free water. She's invested in public safety and made the first increase in firefighters in a generation, hiring 12 new firefighter paramedics. Now Mayor Katie has a plan to lower utility costs, help small businesses grow, and expand manufacturing jobs. Katie Rosenberg for mayor. She's getting results for you.
When you bank with People's State Bank, you're never alone when it comes to your finances. In fact, in a recent survey, customers said our bankers were helpful, flexible, and willing to work with their situation more than any other response. So if you're going it alone with your bank, we invite you to join our community and experience what it's like with People's State Bank on your side. Visit us at bankpeoples.com.
Back in a winter wonderland, feeling like middle of winter, right? Even though we are at the end of March, it's spring, right? It's been winter, but we were pretty much a winter without a winter. But now Mother Nature is like, I got you guys. I'll sprinkle just a little bit more snow before I am all said and done. And spring finally starts to arrive. A little bit of snow still left over up into the UP, northern Minnesota, same story into northern Wisconsin. Now that rain and snow we had just a few days ago, look at this, all the way stretching from pretty much from Florida right up into New York and into Maine. So they are going to deal with a lot of rain. We're talking inches of rain, possibly 3 or more inches in some spots the next couple of days. That's in the East Coast. For us, though, we're going to clear up. Tonight, though, and not quite. We're going to continue to see the mainly cloudy skies and these scattered snow showers all over the area. More of the heavier bands of snow right up into the UP, the Marquette area, right up into Ashland, Iron Counties, Duluth area, and then into northeastern parts of Minnesota. That's going to clear up by tomorrow, right? Abundance amount of sunshine. We're in the clear. By Friday, we are in the clear as well. By Friday night into Saturday, quick moving low pressure system. This is going to be a clipper system, mainly on a clipper system, very light, and it's going to be passing by. It does look like we might possibly get a burst of snow into the Northwoods. Central Wisconsin, more of that rain and snow mix. Southern Wisconsin, more of a rain event with temperatures right around freezing in the Northwoods, slightly below in some spots, and then well above freezing into southern and central Wisconsin. This is going to be Friday night into Saturday. Quick moving system. We'll keep an eye on things. Might produce a quick inch or two for us, but we are still several days away. We'll keep an eye on things. And then Sunday night into Monday, does look like a little bit more rain into central, southern and central Wisconsin, possibly making its way up into the Northwoods. Maybe a couple of sprinkles or some flurries will be possible on Monday, but we will keep an eye on things. It doesn't look like it's going to be not even close as quite as big of a system as what we were experiencing just pretty much 24 hours ago, right? 27 degrees. That was our high temperature today, right up into the UP. Some upper 20s. Iron Mountain was at 30 degrees, but there was still some milder air, right? Central Wisconsin, we saw some mid to upper 30s. Check out Waupaca, a whopping 38 degrees earlier today, melting all of that snow away down south. Average high, though, here in Rhinelander, 43 degrees. Average low should be around 22. So we're going to continue to stay well below that for tomorrow. And then by Friday, closer to average temperatures for Good Friday, right? Wind speed wise, though, anywhere around 10-15 miles per hour. We do have some gusty winds right by Mosinee area into Marshfield. We're talking sustained winds around 18 miles per hour with wind gusts around 30 in some spots. We're going to continue to see some breezy winds tonight, tomorrow. By Friday, much lighter winds and just a light breeze. Tonight, though, pretty gusty winds, mainly cloudy skies and some scattered snow showers will be possible. Temperatures in those mid-teens. Tomorrow, mid-30s outside, partly cloudy skies and breezy conditions. Our 7-day outlook brought to you by Northwoods Furniture and Mattress does show the wintry mix on Saturday. Then we're in the clear for Easter. Jessica?
The search and recovery effort in Baltimore is now a salvage operation. Authorities say the remains of two missing workers have been recovered by divers Wednesday as investigators continue their probe into why a massive cargo ship slammed into the Francis Scott Key Bridge. The two workers were part of a crew filling in potholes on the bridge when it collapsed into the river early Tuesday morning. Officials say recovering the other victims now needs to be put on hold.
Divers are no longer able to safely navigate or operate around that. We have exhausted all search efforts in the areas around this wreckage.
As for the other four men, they are presumed dead. We now know the NTSB has recovered the ship's voyage data recorder and is beginning interviews with the ship's crew members and witnesses. That glass of wine you love so much may not have as much time left as you think. Scientists say 90% of the world's wine-growing regions may have to close up shop by the end of the century because of climate change. A new review published in Nature Reviews Earth and Environment says more droughts and heat waves may make grape production impossible. Regions that could be impacted include Spain, Italy, Greece, and Southern California. Milwaukee Brewers fans, it's looking like you'll have to wait one more day to watch your team in action. Coming up, Sal Meyer will be here to tell us the new date for the Brewers opening day game.
At Blaine's Farm and Fleet, we get you outdoors because we get you. Whether you're ready to hit the road, tackle the yard, or start a new project, we get you the right products at the right prices. Like 20-pound bags of Blaine's brand black oil sunflower seed, just $12.99. These Scott's Turf Builder products start at $64.99 after sale and mail-in rebate. All Longfield spring bulbs, 15% off. And all Bucket Boss tool bags and accessories, 20% off. We get you outdoors because we get you at Blaine's Farm and Fleet.
I'm Karen from the Hearing House. You probably already know that hearing loss is caused by many different things. But if you have hearing loss, the only thing that matters is what you do next. And to do nothing is the worst thing. Start the path to better hearing by calling a professional you can trust, who's going to listen, who's going to take the time to get to know you, who's going to be there when you need them. If you're ready to address hearing loss, call us at the Hearing House. Hearing aids are all we do, so we do it right.
Take your house.
We forge steel bars
that hold up bridges, propel ships, and send rockets into space.
But for years, China's been lowballing their prices,
so it's been tough to compete.
We can't let China steal Wisconsin jobs, so I wrote a law to require American infrastructure projects use American iron and steel.
Tammy Baldwin got President Trump to sign her Made in America bill.
And then she got President Biden to make it permanent.
I'm Tammy Baldwin. I approve this message.
Tammy Baldwin has our back.
Coming up on NewsWatch 12 today, we'll be joined by representatives of the Rylander School District to talk about the upcoming referendum.
Sounds very exciting, right? And temperatures are going to be warming up. What will it look like this week? More to tune in on your Thursday from 5 to 7.
No Bucks fans, you did not experience deja vu Tuesday night. They did indeed lose to the Los Angeles Lakers without LeBron James for the second time this season. Last time, it was a thriller of a game that saw the Lakers win a close one. And this time, same result, but adding two overtimes to get there. The Lakers ended up winning this game 128-124 to take down the Bucks without LeBron James for the second time this season. Giannis Antetokounmpo recorded another triple-double, but it wasn't enough to combat Austin Reeves' triple-double to get his team the win. The Bucks head coach Doc Rivers talks about what went wrong for his team in that game.
When you have a team down, I think it was 18, right?
you have a chance to take that to 30. And we didn't do that. We took it from 18 to 10, coming right out of the door.
Coach Rivers also credits his team's loss to their lack of physicality when his team got a double-digit lead late in the game.
First half, I thought it was us. In the second half, I thought it was them. The first half, I thought we were by far the more aggressive team, the more physical team. Third, fourth, and overtime, it was all them.
The Bucks will look to get back in the win column on Thursday when they travel to New Orleans to take on the Pelicans. Here's a look at the Eastern Conference standings after that Bucks loss to the Lakers. In first place still are the Boston Celtics, followed by the second place Bucks. After those two teams are the Cleveland Cavaliers, the New York Knicks, and the Orlando Magic to round out the top five teams in the conference. The standings are definitely heating up with teams like the Bucks only having 10 games left in the regular season before the playoffs start back up. Brewers fans, Thursday has been a day marked on y'all's calendars all year long. Opening day is finally here, except it's not. If you had opening day for the crew marked for Thursday, March 28th, you'll have to wait one more day. Due to the bad weather happening in the New York area, the Milwaukee Brewers announced that their opening day game against the Mets will be postponed to Friday, March 29th at around 1 p.m. With only three games left this season, Wisconsin Wendigo are still on pace to repeat as NAHL Midwest Division champs and have already clinched a playoff spot for the second straight season. Let's take a look at the rest of the standings for the Midwest Division. The top three teams are the Wendigo, the Anchorage Wolverines, and the Janesville Jets, who have all clinched a spot in the Robertson Cup playoffs. After them, it's the Chippewa Steel, the Minnesota Wilderness, the Fairbanks Ice Dogs, the Springfield Junior Blues, and the Kenai River Brown Bears to round out the rest of the standings. We'll be right back after the break.
Hop on over to the Easter Weekend Beat the Clock Sale, Friday, Saturday, and Monday at Furniture and Appliance Mart. Get savings up to 40% off clearance and special buy appliances, plus special financing for 60 months only at Furniture and Appliance Mart.
Washington has become corrupt. Career politicians sell themselves to special interests and end up working for them and not you. I've worked hard, been fortunate. I don't need their special interest money, and I won't take it. If you decide to elect me as your next senator, I'll donate my entire salary to a Wisconsin charity every year. I'm Eric Hovde. I can't be bought, and I'll put you and our country first. I approve this message.
Get an 11% rebate on everything at Menards. Keep your devices powered with Energizer Max batteries. They deliver consistent performance and have lasting power. A 24-pack of AA or AAA batteries are $14.99 after rebate. Gorilla Tape provides great results for quick fixes around the house. It grips smooth, rough, and uneven surfaces. Rip it, stick it, done. A 30-yard roll is just $7.49 after 11% rebate.
Save big money at Menards.
I've been with U.S. Cellular for years now, and I think I'm their biggest fan. So they asked me to tell you about their special customer event, Us Days. Us Days means exclusive deals just for us customers, like up to $1,200 to upgrade to any new phone. So I said, if I'm going to be on TV, do you think I can get hair and makeup? And I even got a manicure, too.
Introducing Us Days at U.S. Cellular. Exclusive offers just for our customers. Get up to $1,200 to upgrade to any new phone.
This is Ford Truck Month with amazing offers across an amazing lineup of Ford trucks. Make way for the event that only comes around once a year, featuring the new 2024 Ford F-150 and Super Duty, the North American Truck of the Year. Get ready and get to Ford Truck Month. Choose Flex Buy on F-150 with 1.9% APR financing for 66 months, plus 2,000 Flex Buy and 1,000 Open Trade Assist cash at your Wisconsin Ford dealer.
Hop on over to the Easter Weekend Beat the Clock Sale, Friday, Saturday, and Monday at Furniture and Appliance Mart. Get savings up to 40% off clearance and special buy appliances, plus special financing for 60 months only at Furniture and Appliance Mart.
Welcome back. The Crystal Rock Ballroom has a deep history in the Northwoods. Tonight, Gary Bladorn gives us a look at the facility's past in tonight's part one of Connecting the Dots.
Connecting the Dots, reliving Northwood's history with Carrie Bladorn.
Located just west of Rhinelander, Wisconsin, this property holds a special significance as the former site of a beloved local landmark, the fabulous Crystal Rock Ballroom. Affectionately known as The Rock, this venue played a pivotal role in the Northwoods community, serving as a backdrop for cherished memories and life events. For many, this was the place where they saw their first live music, shared their first kiss, met their significant other, got married, went to a dance, celebrated a momentous occasion, supported a charity, or simply learned how to roller skate. Crystal Rock was a place where history and memories were made. The Crystal Rock traces its history back to Milwaukee natives Frank and Gladys Ledua, or Pat as she was better known. In his youth, Frank was a minor league baseball pitcher for several teams, including the Fond du Lac Panthers and the Milwaukee Fault Corporation, even attracting the attention of the Milwaukee Brewers before the Braves came to town. Frank and Pat would relocate their young family to the Northwoods of Wisconsin in the late 40s and purchase Rest Bay Resort on Crescent Lake. Frank began a construction business and developed a style of concrete architecture dubbed Duostone, which can still be seen in Rhinelander and other Northwoods towns today. Frank continued to play ball for a local team called the Shorties, sponsored by the Rhinelander Brewing Company. In 1955, they embarked on an ambitious project of building a ballroom just off of Highway 8, 5 miles west of Rhinelander. The Leduas didn't just have it built, Frank actually built it, with the whole family pitching in. They adorned the dance floor with a striking crystal ball that would inspire its name. The grand opening of Crystal Rock on June 22, 1957, marked the beginning of an era filled with music, dance, and celebration. The ballroom's versatility made it a popular choice for weddings and community events, solidifying its status as a cultural hub in the area. It included a bar, and Pat ran an in-house catering and floral arrangement business there as well. In the following years, the Leduas developed a relationship with John Moss, who ran a booking agency out of Wausau. Over the years, the venue hosted a diverse array of performers, from local bands to nationally renowned acts. The Rock hosted Grand Ole Opry star Johnny Cash on three separate occasions. Early rock and roll acts such as the Fenderman, the Everly Brothers, and Carl Perkins performed there. The Jimmy Dorsey Band, Glenn Miller protege Hal McIntyre, and other big band era orchestras performed at The Rock. America's King of Polka, Frank Yankovic, and comedian Minnie Pearl also graced the stage. Most famously, Buddy Holly and the Crickets performed at Crystal Rock on July 13, 1958, the summer before he tragically died in a plane crash. Many of the acts that performed at Crystal Rock stayed at the Leduas Resort. On one occasion, Frank Yankovic fell asleep on a swim raft on Crescent Lake. He was so sunburned, he struggled to perform a show. Pat Ledua later reminisced that Johnny Cash and the Everly Brothers were very nice young men, that Buddy Holly was not very personable, choosing to spend time before and after their set waiting in their cars in the parking lot, which they slept in across the street from the Rock that night. Buddy Holly's grueling tour schedule and the fact that one of their touring vehicle's tires had been slashed in Wausau the night before might have accounted for his less than friendly visit. Still, he played all of his hits to a packed house at the Crystal Rock.
At Wausau Hearns Furniture, we want you to save. During the month of April, we will pay the sales tax.
Wait. I can do better than that. This April, Hearns Furniture will pay the sales tax and then some, only at Wausau Hearns Furniture.
Once the scar tissue has formed, it decreases mobility to the joint and you lose blood supply. This causes chronic pain.
It's not invasive and you don't even feel it really. And I'm able to work out really good now without any pain at all.
Lasers can eradicate scar tissue, freeing the joint and giving you back your life.
Getting results for Wausau. That's Katie Rosenberg. As mayor, Katie has worked hard to ensure everyone in Wausau has access to safe, PFAS-free water. She's invested in public safety and made the first increase in firefighters in a generation, hiring 12 new firefighter paramedics. Now Mayor Katie has a plan to lower utility costs, help small businesses grow, and expand manufacturing jobs. Katie Rosenberg for mayor. She's getting results for you.
There's never been a better time to switch to Spectrum. Spectrum Internet offers speed and reliability, while advanced Wi-Fi gives you best-in-class security for all your connected devices. And Spectrum Mobile delivers unlimited talk, text, and data with nationwide 5G included. Switch now and get Spectrum Internet for $49.99, plus advanced Wi-Fi and one Spectrum Mobile Unlimited line free for 12 months. Start saving today. Visit Spectrum.com, a Spectrum store, or scan to call now.
Marco
Polo!
Marco
Polo!
Marco
Polo!
Marco Polo?
Get lost in the biggest showroom in the USA. We will beat any deal by $500. Then power your new boat with Suzuki Outboards. Three giant showrooms of boats, pontoons, and Suzuki Outboards only at American Marine, Shawano.
At Wausau Hearns Furniture, we want you to save. During the month of April, we will pay the sales tax.
Wait, wait, wait. I can do better than that. This April, Hearns Furniture will pay the sales tax and then some. Only at Wausau Hearns Furniture.
Builder Service, where your hometown hardware store. Plumbing, electrical, paint, automotive, keys, tools, lawn and garden. We're more than just a lumber yard. Highway 45 in Elko.
Well, you'll be able to see part two of Connecting the Dots tomorrow night at 10.
Let's go.
And I was just thinking, the history of Crystal Rock Ballroom is incredible. They hosted so many interesting acts.
It's so cool. Yeah, I drive through it all the time when I'm going to my games. I'm like, oh, yeah, yeah. Never would think that Buddy Holly would play right. That's just awesome.
Wow. I know, right? And across the street, I don't know if you guys knew this, there was actually an old gas station. Do you guys see that? Right? Like right across the street, old gas station. I mean, I feel like they don't use it anymore. I mean, I think it's like a supermarket or something out there now.
Something like that.
Yeah, very interesting. I love learning about the history.
I know.
It's so cool. And I'll tell you a little bit more history about weather.
Okay.
You guys down? You down for that? All right. Let's talk about that. We did have close to 9 inches of snow the last 3 days here in Rhinelander. Exactly what we were thinking. A couple of spots, a little bit more, and definitely starting to wind down now. A couple of scattered snow showers will be possible overnight. Not possible. They're going to happen for sure. Winter weather advisories are posted up into the UP and winter storm warnings. Snowfall wise, though, probably around a trace, less than half an inch for sure. Here in town, a lot higher totals, closer to the UP and then up into the UP. We're going to be nice for Good Friday and once again for Easter, but right in between that, you see that little sandwich on Saturday? Rain and snow will be possible.
Thank you, Conrad. We'll see you back here tomorrow.
They say that breakfast is the most important meal of the day. Well, they are correct.
Enjoy one of our tasty bagel sandwiches paired with a caramel frappe.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. The Honda you want is here. Get a great offer on the stylish HR-V or the Civic, which Car and Driver calls fun to drive. There's never been a better time to drive in the moment with Honda. Buy online, reserve from select dealers, or hurry into your local Honda dealer today.
You've got this. You didn't think your sister would take you up on the dog sitting offer, but here you are. Barriers? Purchased. Doggy distractions? No expense spared. Yeah, you've got this. Just like Associated Bank's got you with $50 overdraft grace zone. So when you have to make a purchase, or seven, to prepare, you can be sure we're looking out for you. So you can look out for him. You've got this with Associated Bank.
Welcome to Leisure City.
where relieving stress and bringing more fun into your life is what we're all about. You'll notice new faces around, but we're still delivering the same great service we have since 1985. Come see our full lineup of hot tubs in a variety of sizes and styles. We're sure to have that perfect fit for you and your family. Check out our full line of indoor-outdoor patio furniture.
That's Leisure City, your backyard headquarters of the North.
Sinking driveway? Settling patio? Collapsing stoop? Uneven pool deck? It's a fact. Concrete problems don't get better with time. They get better with